It's bye-bye Birdie, the last of the Redbird trains that once made up most of the city's subway fleet, made its last stop today. Pauline Liu is there.
All aboard as the last Redbird subway train took a final sentimental journey on the number 7 Flushing line before being retired from passenger service. The 11-car train was packed with transit officials, off-duty MTA employees, and self-proclaimed subway buffs.
The lights had used to flicker on and off when we used to, diverging tracks, and it's gonna be...
You're gonna miss that?
Yeah. I mean, people are gonna think like, you're crazy.
Yeah, they're my memories. They're the last subway cars that have paint on them. Everything else now is stainless steel, so it's looking a little plain now, They were called Bluebirds at the time, and they were painted in these colors for the 1964 World's Fair. Blue and white was the state color. They turned red about 1985. They painted them red to try to combat the graffiti problem.
For decades, subway riders have called themselves straphangers, but no more. This, in fact, is the last train in the entire system that still has metal hand straps.
These were the backbone of the New York City transit fleet. They operated here for some 50 years.
Most of the Redbird fleet was built 40 years ago by the St. Louis Car Company. They've been replaced by more efficient stainless steel trains. More than 1,100 Redbird cars have been dumped off the Atlantic coast to create artificial reefs. Flushing was the end of the line for this train. A round of applause as it pulled into the station.
A little sad, yes, but it's good to see the new technology.
Transit officials expect the train will wind up in the Transit Museum, where it can continue to take visitors on a ride down memory lane. In Queens, I'm Pauline Liu for the WB11 News at 10.